crafters, welcome to tonight's Art with Heart Calypso Coral Color Hop. Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is a card that I'm going to be showing you how to make tonight. So to gather up your materials, you're going to need a thick basic white card base, just your standard size. I've done an A-frame, so that's 14.8 by 10.5. Then you're going to need a piece of basic white cardstock, which is 14.3 by 10 centimeters in width. You're going to need a piece of Calypso Coral that measures 5.5 centimeters by, I think that one is also 14.3. So 5.5 centimeters by 14.3. Then you've got this one, which is 5 centimeters by 14.3, a bit of or a large piece of Calypso Coral that you can cut out this gorgeous die, which I'll show you in a minute where that comes from, and a piece of white scrap that you're going to do your sentiment on, and I'm going to show you our sentiment. You will also need, if you desire, to have these gorgeous in color shimmer gems. So these are the 2024-2026 in color shimmer gems. We're just going to be using the peach color down the bottom here, so you'll need those. As for the dies, so this gorgeous die cut here comes from the Encircled in Nature dies, so that'll cut that out in a piece of Calypso Coral. And from the Unbounded Love, I'm going to be using the Feel Better Soon sentiment, followed by having the Encircled in Nature. So this goes with those dies. So this can actually be ordered as a bundle, and it comes with the stamp set, and we're going to be using this beautiful flower pattern here. Okay, so now that you've got your materials all together, let's get making. To make this card, I have already die cut our Calypso Coral wreath die cut. So that's already been done from the Encircled in Nature dies. So I'm going to put that to the side. We're not going to need that yet. I have also taken the first layer and I have dry embossed that with the Timber 3D embossing folder. So just put that one, that's the first thing we're going to get started with, and we'll get back to these two here. So now it all depends on how you make the card. Today I'm going to build up my card, but some people would like to build their layers first, and then so it all depends on your personal preference. Today, just for time's sake, I'm going to build from my card base. So first of all, just some multi-adhesive glue, and we're going to adhere that to our base. And so you just got looking for a nice little border. Now we do the 14.3 to give ourselves a bit of an even border around the top, the sides and the bottom. So we're going to glue that onto our base. Okay. And then the next part that we're going to do, now just notice I've got a little bit of an overreach here, so if you're concerned about that, you can go ahead and trim that. I'm leaving it for now. Right, the next thing that we needed to do was glue on our Calypso Coral. This is just straight down the center. So again, multi-adhesive glue. And center it. Top of the embossed piece to the bottom of the embossed piece. Straight down the center, eyeballing that it's even. And again with our piece of DSP. Oh, this DSP is from, I believe, no, I don't believe, I know, it's from the Unbounded Love DSP. Oh, we're going to, now there is a directional pattern to this, so right now my bottom of my card is here, so I'm just making sure that my flowers are also going the direction again, just a border on both sides but no border at the top, and just eyeballing that we've got it pretty even on both sides. All right, and the next little bit is where it gets a little tricky. So that's where we're going to bring in our dye. It is going to be centered, but we're going to put small pieces of dimensional on these overhanging pieces here. We'll glue these, but here we need some dimensional. Otherwise, it kind of flops to the side. So we want to lift those up a bit, because it just happens because of your layers, you know. So I guess initially we just need to know what's top and what's bottom. So our card goes this way, and that's how I would like it. Just gonna leave that there for now. And yes, so sorry if I didn't mention at the start, in your materials that you need to gather together, also grab your dimensionals. So I've got the mini dimensionals, which are fine for some of these larger bits, but you're probably going to have to cut some of these dimensionals down, so I'll need a pair of scissors for that. No squeaky chair, brand new chair, yay. Look at that, you didn't hear me. Okay, these are just, I'm not using my paper trimmers because I do like to cut paper with them, so just grabbing an ordinary pair of scissors. I do have this little piece of foam down the bottom, which is a scrap from like the top part here, so this can easily be cut into smaller pieces. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then I'm going to probably need, I don't know, 6 to 8 little pieces. And for me to get them onto this card, I might use my take your pick tool again, scooting over. You could use tweezers. I'm gonna go for the take your pick tool. Okay, so not going to move it too much. Just going to scoot that over, and I'm going to be focusing on adding to these bits that are overhanging here and here, those bits of dies. So yep, going in with my take my pick tool, kind of picking it up piece by piece. I've got 3 pieces there. That's all right, I'll deal with it. I'm going to put, once it's kind of stuck, you should be able to move those other ones away. Doesn't matter how you do it, as long as you do it right. Okay, just doing our best, just trying to hide it behind the cardboard. Okay, a little bit of a tricky piece there, it's okay. I'm not going to worry about the inside bit because that will be easily glued, so just keeping on focusing on these outside bits. This bigger one will be good over here. Okay, and then the next thing, of course, is you've got to go back and take off the take off the cover of the thing. Okay. I think that one might have lost its top. So, and over, we need to do this one here. Just going to check that. I think this one's actually going to get glued, so I went a little bit too high there. We'll just peel that off and we'll just place that on there again, have a little look. I'm not worried about here because as you can see on the original one, it gets covered here. So yep, so I'm not going to worry about here. Just make sure I've got here. So yeah, I can feel. Just up here, we need some. There and there. All right, so that's all the bits that I've cut, and I'll put it on here again and just check. This be around about there, and that's good. That's going to be covered. I'll probably go up a bit more actually. Okay, so that's good. That's good. I feel like we need some here. Yeah, I feel like we need more on this side. Okay, so we'll cut some more. Oh, I forgot about that. One of these is missing his back. Okay, so we need to go from here and down. Is that right? No, not there. From here. Okay, from here down. So cut some more. We need to take the cover from our dimensionals off. Okay, I'm going to come in now with our glue. Just add some dots. Bring in our card base in, find in the middle, okay. Set your card to the side and we're going to do some stamping. I bring in a scrap piece of white, basic white. You also need Calypso Coral. And bring out the flower image from the Encircled in Nature. And also your die, because we're going to cut this out with the die. Okay, let's stamp that on. Bring in a light Calypso Coral Stampin' Blend and a dark soft sea foam. And we're going to colour our flowers with our, so we're going to use our brush end and we're going to colour our flowers in Calypso Coral. We're going to make the centre part darker than the rest. And we do that just by going over it a couple of times. More than what we go over the petals. Just maybe 3 or 4 times. Okay, so the next one I'm going to start doing the petals. And the stamp is done in such a way that I don't need to really do a lot of blending between the dark and the light. I'm going to be using the lines as my boundaries. And in with my brush of the dark soft seafoam. Dad, don't remember where I saw it or who did it. I just noticed I have got an outline here of the dye that I'm about to do, and the tip was to place this over the top of what you want to cut and get it so that you're happy with like the outline. And then what you do is you come back with the dye and you sit the dye in there. And then it should actually cut perfectly. So let's see. Let's find out. Okay, let's see how that idea went. Check that out, that's cool. It's a good idea. Okay, what are we gonna do? We are gonna bring this in and we're going to adhere it to our card base. Okay, we'll get some multi-purpose glue and I think a bit of glue along the middle, a couple of dimensionals, along this outside edge, and one more. And I wouldn't do any on the inside, okay, because it's on the layer there. Okay, so we'll grab that, we'll grab the unglued bit on the inside there, and around about the middle. And we'll leave that one to peep out there. And yeah, whoopsies, kind of, maneuvering it around a little bit. That's all good. Okay. Oh, do you know what I've done? Didn't take off the backing, did I? Goodness me. There we go. Okay. Back in. Try that again. A little bit peeping out here. And bringing it around. There we go. Gorgeous. Okay. Yeah, that's good. Okay. Stamp our sentiment. So we'll bring in that little bit of, here it is. So we'll bring in this little bit of scrap. Sorry, you've got a nice little slide there. So I'm going to use that and just stamp our Feel Better Soon in Calypso Coral. So I'll just line this up on a bit of, on a line on our glass mat here. Okay, ink up our sentiment and then close to that cut edge but nice and straight. There we go. Lovely. Okay. And then just another little slanted cut. And also King Baker's Twine Essentials Pack, and we are using the crumb cake. All right, this is the crumb cake, just cut off about 25 centimeters. That's enough twine to give you a nice some room to do a bow. So 25 centimeters. Yes, I'm being a bit lazy, not bringing my trimmers. My paper snips in, that's going to get glued on there. But first of all, we're going to turn this into a bow. I like to wet my string just to give it, so it stops curling. So I'll just go and do that and I'll be back. All right. So to make your bow, there's the middle. So we kind of want a little bow on that side, a little bow on that side, and trying to use this, kind of even amount of string on each side. So you make your little ears, and then your little ear goes through the hole, and then we have our little bow. And then adjust your bow loops to what you would like. Tighten it. And pull until you're happy with what it looks like. That's good. Yep, I'm happy with that. And you bring in a glue dot. And I'm going to put a glue dot on the back of where my little knot is. I'm going to do that. I take a pick tool. It helps me just to lift that up there like that. Okay. And that bow is going to go on my card. A bit more sideways, like that. Okay, we'll give those a trim in a minute, but we've got one that's going to come down a bit like that. Bring our, okay, so that's going to go across there. Yep, so we'll get some dimensionals, and I'm going to put dimensionals kind of on that half away from the bow, so the half away from the bow, and some glue where the bow is. Take pick tool is really good for taking the layer off the backs of your dimensionals. All right, and then just kind of going to go over the top of the bow and let's make sure it's straight. You get a nice straight sentiment. Yeah, about that. Okay, and so your dimensionals just give it that lift. Because your knot is giving it a little bit of a lift too. And now we're going to come in with our In Color Shimmer Gems. So we're going to grab a nice big one and we'll pop that just on here. And we'll grab another big one. We'll pop that on the white a bit high, and then a smaller one, and that can go on the white. So we're just using the three, just to the side there, like so. Okay, so that was the original we made. This is the one we made today. And on the inside, I've just left this card blank. And because I've used a no waste template, I don't have any DSP left over to pop on the inside. So that's great. I hope you enjoyed making the card with me tonight, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Bye.